we said. Now we need the floor slab, or the floor where you will walk in when you go inside the house. So I will just come here to the top of you. Now I will start doing the same thing again. PL, enter for the floor slab, and then go all around the line that you have here. All the outside points only, not the inner points, only the outer points. Come back here to all the points until we reach the first one. So here, when you reach the first one, don't click on it, just select close. Now you have the line. When you select it, you can click on extrude, and then the height will be 450 as well, the same as the last step you had. So now you have it like this. After this, we need to start with the walls. For the walls, we cannot use polyline because it will make it all one closed area. So I will just change the view here, or the visual style, to 2D wireframe. For the walls, you can select polysolid. So polysolid is to create a 3D wall. When you select polysolid, you cannot just start drawing. You need to come here and change the height, width, and justify. So if you go to the sections that you have, you can see in the section here that the height for the wall is 2750, which means when you select polysolid, you need to come to the height and change it to 2750 and press enter. Then the width is the standard, which is 200. As for justify, you can change it to left or right, it's up to you. Now I'm selecting right. Now when you come to draw here, sometimes it will show like this. You can select all the lines. Sometimes it will not be drawing on the line. You can see like there is a blue frame all around. If you had this frame, you can click on F6. Now you can select all the points from inside. So start clicking on the first point. Make sure that you are inside the wall, not outside, not like this. And then click on all the outer edges, nothing inside, all the outer edges. And then go all around. Make sure that your points are correct. If you have any wrong point, click on Ctrl and Z. So Ctrl and Z will delete the last step only, not everything. Then go back to your points. Make sure to zoom in when you are clicking. Don't just click when you are zooming out, so you can make sure that you have the same, the correct point, not the wrong one. Then when you reach here, you can select close to close all the walls. Now you can see here that we have all the walls. You can click on conceptual to see everything. Of course, this layer or this wall need to be in 3D walls layer, and as you can see, it's starting from the ground, so we need to take it up by 450. So I will just select the wall, type move, enter, and then select this point here and move it up to here. So when I click here, it will be like this. They will be. So first you will select the last point here and then put it above the floor slab. Now we have the walls. After this, we will start with the roof ceiling or the roof slab.